Hi students, welcome to online classes. We are going to study about switchgear and protection. In this circuit interrupting device unit 2, in this video we are going to see isolator. What is the use of isolator? How it is going to work? We are going to see one by one. Isolator is a no load switch. It can be operated under the no load only. हम लोग केवल no load में isolator को use कर सकते हैं. अगर load चालू है तो हम लोग isolator को नहीं संभालना है. Circuit breaker always trips the circuit, but the open contacts are not visible physically from outside. Outside of the breaker, we cannot confirm that the breaker is opened or not. For better safety, we are using isolators. Here you can see, this is how the circuit breaker will be like this. So inside this, there will be one fixed contact. यहाँ से हम लोग input दे रहे हैं. मान लीजिए यहाँ से हम लोग output लेके जा रहे हैं. So this is the movable contact, means it will be connected here. There will be connection. When the fault occurred, what happens? This contact is going to move from here to here. Then circuit is opened. But we don't know whether it is opened or not. Why? Because it is closed in a chamber. It is closed in a box. So it is not visible. If we want to operate on this line, हम लोग कुछ repair करना है इसके ऊपर, हम लोग we cannot do with a confidence. Why? Because it is not visible. This is the reason we are keeping in series this. We are going to keep one more device, that is isolator. What this isolator will do, it is a no load switch, means it will be connected like this. Okay, when we switch off it, it will come here. So we can see easily whether the circuit is opened or not. Clearly we can see from here. Here you can see the diagram of the isolator. This is how the isolator will be. We'll see ahead different types of isolators, how these are going to work. Isolators are classified into three types. First one is double break isolator, second single break isolator, third pantograph isolator. Double break type, single break type, pantograph type, isolators. These are the three. First we will see, here you can see this is a symbolic representation of single break isolator and double break isolator. Now we are going to learn about double break type isolator. Here you can see this type of isolator consists of three loads of post insulators. The middle isolator holds the flat male or tubular contact that can be turned slightly by a pin of the middle isolator. So here if you see, the isolator will be like this. Center one will holds the pot. Okay, there will be three post insulators. Center one will host this tubular. The rotation of the middle post insulator can be done by a here if you see, it is connected to one lever mechanism. When it is pushed like this, the isolator will be opened like this. When it is pushed from this side, it will be closing. This is how it is going to work. Double break type isolator. Here we can see diagram. This is the double break type isolator. This one, at the time of normal condition, it will be like this. This is a rod. If you see the arrangement here, this is like this. When the rod comes, it will hold the rod. Here also same arrangement will be there, but it is opposite in direction. Okay, it will rotate like this. Here you can see. So from this lever we are going to operate. We are going to on and off with this lever. Okay. Next. Here you can see double break type disconnector, how it is going to work. At the last, there is a huge sound because of the arc. We will see what is arc in next slides. In coming slides, we are going to learn about what is arc and how it is going to be. Next type is single break type isolator. In this type of isolator, the arm contact is separated into two elements. The first arm contact holds the male contact, as well as second arm contact holds the female contact. The arm contact shifts because of the post insulator rotation upon which the arm contacts are fixed. Here you can see, this is single break type. One will be like this, and it will be holding the contact. Second one will consist of the tubular rod. It will have the rod that is fixed here, and it will be operated with one more insulator. You can see diagram in next slide. Single break type isolator. This is how. Here you can see, when it comes to here, the height will be this much. So the rod is going to open. This is a single break type. Here you can see the video how it is going to work. This one we say center break type. This one is the male contact. This one is the, sorry, this is female contact. This is male contact. The next type is pantograph type isolator. The pantograph type isolator permits the current switchgear installation, and it requires the least space. This type of isolator includes a post insulator as well as an operating insulator. जहाँ हम लोग को बहुत कम स्पेस है वहाँ हम लोग ये यूज कर सकते हैं, इसके लिए बहुत कम स्पेस है ये. और एक्चुअली हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, ये आइसोलेटर जो है आर वाई बी, तीनों फेसेस के लिए तीन अलग अलग आइसोलेटर्स चाहिए. मान लीजिए एक एक के लिए मैंने हियर इफ सपोज R is having this much height. R is having this much height. Y is having this much height. B is has this much height. If suppose we use double break is like this. So we need equal height. लेकिन हम लोग को यहाँ थोड़ा disturbance हो गई, equal height नहीं हो पा रहे. यहां हम लोग को पैंटाग्राफ अच्छे से काम करेगा. सो दिस इज हाउ द पैंटाग्राफ आइसोलेटर विल बी लुक्स लाइक. सी दिस अरेंजमेंट विल से पैंटाग्राफ आइसोलेटर. Okay, why we are using isolators? To switch on and off. Here you can see pantograph type isolator, how it is going to work. So this is how it is going to work. Here I am going to show you one more. This is one of the latest isolator which is used at more than 440 kilovolts. 440 से ज़्यादा है तो हम लोग को आसान से यूज करने के लिए ये है. You can see this. This is knee type isolator. Here this you can see, these are the four types of the isolators: double break, center break, pantograph, knee type. Thank you.